Hi, I'm Magnus Carlsen from Norway. I'm the world chess champion. I've been that since 2013. I watched the Queen's Gambit with great interest, and I'm here to take you through some of the clips and some of the chess from the series. The chess stuff is incredibly well done. It's also a captivating series in general. Just by the fact that I was watching it with my girlfriend who doesn't actually play chess, and she found it so captivating, and she was the one who was sort of pushing for us to binge it rather than I was, and she doesn't play chess, so. But I don't have that particular memory of buying a chessboard when I was little. The one instance that I do remember of buying a chessboard about 2.5 years ago, where I simply realized that I don't have a chessboard at home. And so what I did is that I just went down to the local billiards shop, which was about 200 meters from where I lived in Oslo, and I bought some chessboard that they had there, and they were obviously pretty surprised that I needed that.
Are you sure you want to do this?
I'm sure.
We don't have a women's section.
Especially in places where there haven't been too much history of women playing chess, there is certainly a tendency for women not to feel all that welcome, and it's been male dominated for so long, and I think a lot of men like want to keep it that way. Girls are just as excited about chess and just as good at chess as boys. The imbalance comes a bit later, and it's probably also more of a case of parents pushing boys more into chess than maybe parents of girls don't want to push them into chess because they think that this will not be an environment that is good for their child. So I think there is definitely a lot to work on there, but I think that in principle there sort of the preconditions should be very, very equal. But unfortunately, it has not happened that way at all. I understand the sort of skepticism in that you can't just waltz and tell them you've never played a rated game, you don't have any rating, and you expect to beat them all, like male or female. That would sound ludicrous coming from anyone. Yeah, I think telling her, there's no women's section is uncalled for. Like, it's like you're here, you should be treated like anybody. This is definitely the case for most tournaments, still, that they're held in fairly low profile locations. I think chess definitely has a way to go there, in the way it's being presented.
Highest rated players in the whole fucking country, and yet here we are in some second-rate university playing on cheap plastic boards with cheap plastic pieces.
Certainly, a sort of new world has opened up, in terms of serious online chess. The only thing I would be worried about long term is the future of sort of classical chess, the one that Beth Harmon is playing, and that has been considered the most prestigious, where you play games over several hours, because online, people don't really practice for these very long games. So long term, we might be sort of raising a generation of players who are much more used to playing speed chess than slower chess. And for the future of the game, I'm not quite sure how that will pan out. But I think overall, chess has done well in these very difficult circumstances that have been. I cannot stress that enough, that I love the way that she respects the game. She never stops studying. She never stops learning. She never stops thinking that she can do better. I'm somebody who has never been great at dealing with defeats. If you take a survey of the best players to ask them who the worst loser is, my name is going to come up. From my own experience along the time of my career, there definitely have been opponents that I struggled with. And I would say that the best example is Anand, who used to be world champion between 2007 and 2013. So when I started out playing at the top level, I struggled a lot against him. It's very, very relatable, the despair she feels towards the end of the game, where you know you've been outplayed, you know there are no chances, you're just desperately looking for something, anything, any chance that you can possibly find. Whenever you lose, like, you start questioning everything, basically. It's really so, so unpleasant. It's such an unpleasant feeling to lose, especially like if you feel like you made mistakes that you could have avoided. For me personally, I just try to channel that anger into the next game. I do like the fact for her that losing is not normal. It's not something that just happens. Like you accept it and then you move on. When you lose, you have to make sure that it doesn't happen again, because it's an awful feeling, and the motivation has to be to avoid feeling that again.
Don't tell.
Mr. Scheibel was certainly an important mentor, but most of all, I think he was just encouraging her to study, and that she would be the best teacher herself. My father taught me the rules, and as I progressed, he certainly taught me a bit, although still mostly I was studying on my own. But later on, we were at a tournament, and we were going through one of my games, and my father made a comment about one of my moves. He suggested something else instead, and one experienced player there, he was just passing by. He just told my father that what he was teaching me was wrong. My father was kind of spooked by this, and after that, he pretty much just left it up to me. He felt that it was much better that I figured it out on my own than he give me poor advice.
The truth of a child. You're astounding.
I hope you guys enjoyed the clips and me talking about it. Hopefully you are more ready now than ever to go out beating your friends or whoever you are playing at chess. So take care and enjoy the game.